Hello YouTube. Today I wanted to talk about something that I spend a lot of time doing and I've done a lot of testing with, and that is shooting cast bullets in military surplus rifles. I have a pretty large collection and a lot of different calibers, and to save money and to go easy on my shoulder, I load some light cast loads. They're very cheap to do. If you cast your own bullets, you can shoot for, you know, something that would normally cost you 50 cents a round or more. You can get it down to basically just the primer, a little bit of powder, and whatever your cost for your lead is, and considering that you're reusing the brass, so maybe 10 cents a round or so. So I've done a lot of different testing, and one of the best manuals or guides for doing this is this article right here by C.E. Harris called Cast Bullet Loads for Military Rifles. If you just enter that title into Google, you'll find plenty of links to this article. And this gives you guidelines for a bunch of different calibers and what powders to use for what grain of cast bullet. And it starts out with a guideline here of just basic 100 yard, 200 yard, and then actual gas check deer hunting loads that, you know, have a higher velocity to where you could actually hunt with them. And you're going to have to do some testing. You may get lucky and your first load that you try will be great. Sometimes some guns just shoot better with cast bullets than others, just depending on the rifling, the bore size, what powder you use, the grain of bullet you use. So there's a lot of trial and error to it, but I find it fun, and saving money is always good. So the first part of this article here tells you that these loads that he gives you here can be used in any post-1898 military rifle from 7mm to 8mm. When you're using a really small 125 grain bullet in any of those calibers, you can use a really fast powder, which will save you the most money, and you can use it as little as 5 grains of bullseye in a full-size military case with a cast bullet. I am not a big fan of the really fast powders. The fastest powder that I like to use is 2400. I have tried Unique and it's okay, but I kind of settled on 2400 being the fastest that I like to use. So when you're up in around 170 to 180 grain load here, and it says gas checked, and that's another thing. These days you can powder coat, and I'm going to go into that later. And in a lot of guns, you can get away with not using a gas check if you powder coat the bullet. Some guns do not like a gas check design bullet without a gas check on it, because it leaves kind of a boat tail almost, and it will not shoot well. Some guns, it doesn't matter, and they will shoot great without the gas check. So I do put gas checks on some of my powder coated bullets, but only if it won't shoot well without one. And your base guideline here for any of these 7mm to 8mm, so 7.65 Argentine, 30-06, 8mm Mauser, 8x56 rimmed, 7.62x54R, you can start with 16 grains of 2400 and then work up from there. If it shoots well with 16 grains and the case seals fine, then just stop there and go with it. Some guns, you're going to have to go higher than 16 grains because the case is not going to seal, and you're going to get singed brass and a puff of gas in your face. This isn't scary, it's not painful, it's not dangerous. It just means the load is too weak and the brass is not expanding fast enough to create a good enough seal to prevent that hot gas from coming back. Now, all these guns are made to redirect gas like that, and so it's not going to hurt you. So it's up to you whether you care about that or not. You can stick with that if 16 grains shoots well, but it still doesn't seal. It's not dangerous to keep shooting those. I always tend to go up in the charge, though, until it will seal. I just don't like getting that puff of gas in my face, and it also, that brass can be harder to clean when that happens. So, for an example, I usually use around 18 grains for a full-size case like 8mm Mauser. I've noticed that in most of my Mausers, and I have a bunch, I have a Yugoslavian, Czech, German, Turkish, and several others, and they seem to have pretty generous chambers, so you need a more stout load than 16 grains usually to get the case to seal. So with an 8mm Mauser, I usually end up somewhere between 18 and up to 20. When you're dealing with 2400 on a full-size case like that, if you're getting accuracy issues or the case is not sealing and you're getting up around 20 grains, I would stop at 20 grains and go to a slower powder. The one that I use the most as far as a slower powder for that kind of issue is Reloader 7. And if you don't have Reloader 7 or you can't get it, 4198 is also a really good one. And you're going to use up around 25, 26 grains or so of that instead of starting with the 16 grains of 2400. As an example here, my 765 Argentine loads, I have settled on 25 grains of Reloader 7, and I'm using a 205 grain powder coated bullet, and those shoot quite well. I sized them to 312, and we're going to talk about bullet size later. That's a really important issue here. So just for target loads, I'm not doing any deer hunting. I'm just punching holes in paper or shooting steel. I'm usually going to be using, you know, 18 to 20 grains of 2400, or go into a slower powder if those won't seal or they won't shoot well, and starting with 25 grains or so of Reloader 7. So you can read this article. There's a bunch of different loads in here to try, and it talks about different powders you can use for smaller cases. As far as the 7.62 by 39, you don't want to use a full-size load in these. And it has an article, and part of the article in here talks about the 7.62 by 39. With 7.62 by 39, you can't use those same loads. So with 2400, I think it says 16 grains is the max in 7.62 by 39 with 2400. You're just going to have to try it in your gun and see whether it will cycle the action or not. I have found that 15.5 grains of 2400 will cycle my AK rifles and my Chinese and Yugoslavian SKS rifles. I've read a lot on the internet of people using up to 16 grains and it won't cycle the action. So if that happens, you need to move to a slower powder. And what I did was I went to 4198 and I started with 19 grains and worked up to 19.5 grains, and I found that those will cycle anything in 7.62 by 39 that I own, and I have two AKs and four SKS rifles, and that 19.5 grains will cycle anything I have. And the bullet that I use is the Lee 155 grain, and I size them to 312, I believe, and they shoot really well at 50 yards. So you have the, say you have the mold, say you have a 7.62 by 39 rifle and you bought this Lee 155 grain mold. I'm sorry if you can hear the neighbors out there sawing lumber. But if you have this mold, you're going to need to size the bullet, and you're going to want to slug your rifle barrels to see how what size you're going to need on that bullet. You're going to want to shoot for about 1/1000th over what your bore diameter is. And the way I do it is I take a piece of buckshot and I put it here at the muzzle, and then I'll pound that in with a short piece of dowel rod until it gets down, it smashes down, fills out the bore, and then I'll get a longer dowel rod and I'll push it all the way through, and I'll put some paper towel down in the bottom of the action to catch it, because this is soft lead. And then you're just going to take your calipers and read the largest diameter that you get, say it's 312. Then you're going to have to decide how you want to size your cast bullets. And there's several ways to do that, and what I use is the Lee push-through sizers. So I'm going to set up and show you how I do that. Okay, so here I am at my press, and I use the Lee type push-through sizers. They come in a little case like this, and basically all it is a die that screws into your press, and then you push the bullet up through it. This sits in your shell holder. This screws in the press. And you buy whatever size you want. This is a 314. And so right here I have a Lyman 314 299 bullet that I have powder coated. And I'm going to size it to 314 with this die. So all you do is sit the base on this shell holder ram and push it up through, and then it's sized. And the case that comes with the Lees is made to sit on top of the die, and it will catch all your bullets as you're doing this. I'm just doing one here just to show you. But all it does is squeeze it down to whatever size you need, depending on the results you get when you slug your bore. And the thing about powder coating, say you buy a Lee mold that's labeled 309, but you want a 310 bullet because you slugged your bore and it's 309 and you want to go a thousandth over. You can sometimes make up for a little bit of diameter with powder coat. Say you take that 309 bullet, don't size it, powder coat it, then push it through the 310 sizer, so you got a 309 bullet with a thousand thickness of powder coat around it. Some guns will shoot okay like that, some of them will not. You'll get really bad leading due to the bullet not obturating properly to seal the barrel. You'll get gas, hot gases that will blow by the bullet out in front of it and melt the powder coating basically, and you'll just have a mess in your bore. So you're gonna have to do trial and error on that. The one bad thing about these Lee dies, you can seat a gas check with them. You just press it on the base and then push it up through here. It does not crimp those gas checks on sometimes, as well as like a Lyman lubricizer, where you're pushing the bullet down into a die, squeezing grease into these grooves, and that will clamp that gas check on better than trying to push it up through one of these and expecting it to stay. So you're just gonna again have to do trial and error on that. If you need a gas check, see how they do. If you end up with them not clamping on good enough, NOE I think makes a gas check seating die, so you can check with them. NOE bullet molds, they are really good. And I bought a bunch of these Lee sizers when I first started out doing this. You know, you have to buy a new one for each size you want. But NOE has made a really awesome system where you just buy one die and then you can switch out the bushings. So all you have to buy for each size is this little piece here. Fits up in here. There's a set screw to hold it in. And then you just buy one of these for each size you want, and it's way cheaper and easier. And so that's what I would do if I was someone starting out and I wanted to use this system, you know, a push-through type system to size my bullets. Definitely check NOE and get this die. It's way cheaper to own more sizes, and when you have a bunch of different military rifles, even if they're the same caliber, they're gonna slug differently. And you're going to need multiple ones of these for each caliber sometimes. Like, for example, my 8x56 rimmed Steyr straight pull M95 carbines. I have some that slug around 330, and I have one that slugs all the way up to 333. So it's supposed to be 329, but a lot of times military rifles have pretty generous bores. And the problem again with Lee is if you look up their die for the 8x56 rimmed, I'm sorry, their mold for the 8x56 rimmed, it is listed as 329, and mine drops a 329 bullet. But none of my rifles slug that tight. They're all at least 330. I have several of them. So basically, that mold is totally useless for me. What I have started doing is using that 329 bullet and sizing it down for 8mm Mauser to about 324. And they come out just fine. They shoot great. If I was someone that had one of those rifles, I would get the 338 Lapua mold and size those down. Otherwise, you're probably going to get really bad leading with that 329 205 grain Lee bullet. I think NOE probably makes a fatter bullet for that, so I would definitely check with them. Lee molds are okay. I use a lot of them, but they are cheap. Some of them are really bad. You're not going to get good bullets. The sprue plate screw is going to come out. It's a real pain. I've ended up drilling and tapping all of mine and putting a set screw in to hold that sprue plate screw in because they all come out. But if you want to spend more money, they're expensive, but they're amazing. Check out this NOE company. It's worth it, I'm telling you. Their bullet molds feel like a Ferrari compared to Lee feeling like a Yugo. So I think that's about it. I'm going to give you some of my load data that I use for some of my guns that end up shooting really well, so you can try some of my loads out if you're going to do this. It's a lot of fun. I'm going to explain my powder coating process. Basically, I cast my bullets. I don't size them. I do the dry shake and bake method. So I take the bare bullets, I put them in a plastic tub with some BBs, some metal BBs. Then I'll dump a couple tablespoons of the powder coat in there and just shake it up. I also sometimes use a tumbler, like an electric rock tumbler, and that gets them really nicely coated. Then I'll put them in silicone ice cube trays that have these little grid on them so that the bullets will stay up. And then I bake them for about 20 minutes. Powder by the pound works pretty well. I've used their durable gloss black. And then this is Eastwood Ford Light Blue. It's probably my favorite. It coats really well. It's nice and tough. They pretty much always come out well. And I've also used a lot of Harbor Freight Red. Those 7.62x39 loads I was showing you was just Harbor Freight Red. And I have never had a problem with that. I'm not sure it's quite as durable as some of the more expensive kinds, but it's been pretty nice. So basically, when you get started, first thing, you need to slug your bore. Then go look at molds and see what your options are with the size that you need. Cast your bullets, buy your sizer, size them, coat them if you want to, or use a regular type of grease lube. You can use the Lee Tumble Lube. It's just like a paste in a tube, and you just shake them up and coat the bullets. Use the gas checks if you need them. Try them both ways. If you don't use them. It just saves you more money. There's no need for them if you're powder coating, usually. Sometimes you still need them. And then download that cast bullet loads for military rifles article. Read through it. Get some loads to try. Buy your powder and just give it a whirl. Don't be scared or worried that you're going to hurt anything. It's pretty forgiving since you're using soft lead bullets. I use, by the way, melted down clip-on wheel weights usually. I buy them scrap from the scrapyard and then clean them up, or you can buy ingots on eBay that are already cleaned up. Just search for wheel weight ingots. Don't get the stick-on type, they're too soft. But if you get the clip-on type, they're pretty much the perfect hardness for using pistol or rifle bullets. So that's about it. I hope that helps someone. It's a lot of fun getting into this if you have military rifles. You can shoot a lot more for a lot less money. The recoil is a lot less, if that bothers you at all. And it's a lot of fun. You can get amazing accuracy. I guarantee I can beat any commercial load with my cast loads. It may take some tinkering, but I guarantee I can match any commercial ammo at 50 yards, and that's where I usually shoot, because with iron sights my eyes aren't great. So I usually stick to 50 yards, and these will shoot fine out to 100 or even further, depending on, you know, what kind of accuracy you're needing. So give this a try if you have military rifles. I think you'll enjoy it. I still load jacketed bullets as well. It just depends on what I'm feeling like that day, whether I'll grab my jacketed reloads or cast reloads or both. If I'm bringing a new shooter out, I'll usually let them shoot cast loads first. You know, taking a new shooter and sticking them behind a M44 Mosin carbine with surplus ammo is probably not the best idea if you're wanting to scare them off. So I'll give them some nice light little cast loads, and you can load these down as light as it feels like a 22. Or you can load them up nice and hot, especially if you're powder coating and using a gas check. You can get some nice velocities. And so it's still a lot of fun. Give it a try. I hope that helps someone out. Okay, another thing I wanted to talk about is the seating the bullet. And when you're working with cast bullets, you're going to have to expand the neck of the case, or else you're going to shave a bunch of lead off when you try to seat it. This is a 303 British case, and that 314 299 bullet that I sized to 314. And as you can see, there's no way you're going to be able to seat that. So you're going to have to expand the case neck somehow. There's ways to do that without special tools. I've heard of people using screwdriver tips or, you know, anything they can fit in the neck to expand it. But Lee makes a neck expander die. Let me adjust this here. Okay, Lee makes this expander die here that has these different shaped wedges, basically, and they're stacked up in here, and you have a little chart that comes with it that tells you which tip to use for different calibers, and you might have to use some trial and error if your caliber is not listed in there. But basically what you're gonna do is bring your ram all the way to the top, and then it works a lot like a bullet seating die. And you're just going to tighten this down until you feel it contact the case mouth, and then adjust it maybe a half a turn, and then try that, and you'll feel it catch. You can hear when I pull the ram back down that little ting sound, and you'll see that it has expanded that neck, if I can get this to focus, just a little bit. And you're just going to adjust it a little bit and then try it, and you want to get it to where that bottom grease groove or driving band will get easily down in the neck to where you're not going to shave any brass or any lead when you're seating it. And that's good there. If you can see, that driving band sits about 3/4 of the way down in there, and that's far enough. You can go a little more if you want. And the problem with this is you're gonna have to squeeze that back down after you seat the bullet, and a good way to do that is the Lee factory crimp die. Those work really well, and When you're working with cast bullets, you do not want to crimp them much. What you need to do is measure this expanded case mouth with your calipers and then adjust this minimally to where you're barely squeezing on it, and then measure again and get it just to where you're going back to normal. You don't want to actually crimp the case, or you're going to squeeze down the driving band of the lead bullet, which can give you accuracy issues or even leading issues. So just squeeze it back down enough to where it's back to normal, and that's all you need to do. So that's about it. I hope you guys learned something from that, and I will see you in the next video.